Welcome back everyone to video number 7, I believe, in your database clustering series. This video we are going to be setting up passwordless SSH. So I changed the background so it'd be a little bit easier to tell the difference between the different virtual machines. So this one with the logo of several nines, well that one is obviously going to be the one that has the cluster control on it. These two over here, these are just the masters. So we have master 1 and master 2. The thing that we want to accomplish is make sure that this computer can communicate with all of the other computers. To begin that process, open up a terminal and type in ifconfig. Now in here, look for the second network card, and you can see that there's this address. This is the machine's IP address. Let's do this on all the machines to see what IPs are assigned to which virtual machines. So go over here, open that up, and repeat the process. You can see that master 1 ends in 102. And master 2 ends in 103. Now from the cluster control computer, there's some commands that we need to run to connect to the other machines. The command that we are interested in is ssh-keygen. When you press enter, you can just press enter a couple times for all of the questions and you'll get this fancy looking picture. This is going to create some files inside of a hidden folder. So if you type in ls-a and then put .ssh, this is going to show all of the files inside of this hidden SSH folder. And you can see there's this ID RSA and then this ID RSA pub. The first one is a private key that you're going to have on this machine. And then there's the public key that you're going to put on the other machines that when you try to connect to them, both of these files are used to see if there is a connection that is allowed. So what we need to do is we need to take this file and put it on the other two machines. And there's actually a command that allows you to do this very easily. So that command is ssh-copy-id, and then you just put the IP address of the other machines. So if we go back, you can see it's 10.71.34.102. So we can just type that in. You want to say yes, and then type in the password for the other machine. And it works. Now, when we set up this machine and cloned it, it actually did something very convenient for us. It made sure that all of the usernames and passwords were the same, and that's actually needed for cluster control. You're going to have one user that has a certain password, and that user is going to have to be on all of the different machines. So we kind of cheated and just cloned the machines entirely. But if you're working in a production environment where you already have these installed, you're going to need to make that user that's on all of them. So we put that public key on master 1, but now we need to do it on master 2. So we just go back and put a 103. Yes. And then password. There you go. Now, this part's a little weird, but you gotta make sure you remember to do this. Cluster control is actually going to need to have passwordless SSH to the machine that it's on. So what that means is we need to do it again, but use the IP address of this machine, which was 101. Yes, and a password. There you go. Now to verify that these worked, you can put SSH and then type in the IP address. So for example, in this situation, we are going to be SSHing into this same machine. It ran, and you can see nothing really happened. There's some output, but the title here is exactly the same. That makes sense though, because we're actually on the same machine. We just can't really tell because the username is exactly the same. And it's actually the same for all of these. If you look, you can see this guy has the same username as this guy. So when you're actually doing SSH yourself, it can be a little bit confusing, but that's okay because we don't really have to worry about that. All we needed to see is that we get some kind of output here. So to escape this, what we do is hold control and press D. And you can see it closed the connection. Now let's try it again with master 1. We get that output. So now in this situation, when we do commands such as ls, we're actually displaying the files that are on this machine. So SSH just allows us to connect to that machine and work with it as if we were using that machine directly. So let's close out of that one and try the other master 103. And you can see it works as well. So make sure you close out of that so you're working with the right computer. And now we are working with the machine that has cluster control on it. So the way we just set up this SSH is called passwordless SSH. You can see when we typed in SSH and put in an IP address, it did not ask us for a password. This is exactly what is needed for cluster control. So we got everything set up, and in the next video, we're actually going to install cluster control. So thank you guys. If you've enjoyed this video, please click like. And as always, please subscribe and share this video with your friends. I'll see you all in the next video, and I think it's going to be a lot of fun, so please check it out. And as always, peace out.